Formaldehyde is a chemical widely used by industry to manufacture building materials and numerous household products. It is also used as a preservative in laboratories, as embalming fluid, and as a sterilizer. Its primary use is in the production of resins and as a chemical intermediate. It is also a byproduct of combustion and certain other natural processes. This means it may present substantial concentrations both indoors and outdoors. As far back as 1987, the Environmental Protection Agency classified formaldehyde as a probable human carcinogen. The International Agency for Research on Cancer does classify formaldehyde as a human carcinogen, and the California Air Resource Board has classified formaldehyde as a toxic air contaminant. Sources of formaldehyde in the home include building materials, smoking, household products such as nail polish and permanent pressed fabrics, and the use of unvented fuel-burning appliances such as gas stoves or kerosene space heaters. In homes, the most significant sources of formaldehyde are likely to be from pressed wood products made using adhesives that contain urea formaldehyde resins. Pressed wood products made for indoor use include particle board, hardwood plywood paneling, and medium-density fiberboard. Medium-density fiberboard is generally recognized as being the highest formaldehyde-emitting pressed wood product. Formaldehyde is also released from some types of insulation. As a gas, formaldehyde is colorless and pungent-smelling. High concentrations may trigger asthma attacks in some people. There is some evidence that people can develop a sensitivity to formaldehyde. Health effects include eye, nose, and throat irritation, wheezing and coughing, fatigue, skin rash, severe allergic reactions, and possibly cancer. Fortunately, there are steps people can take to reduce the exposure in their homes. Do not smoke indoors. Limit the introduction of formaldehyde-containing products and building materials. Use exterior-grade pressed wood products, which are lower emitting because they contain phenol resins, not urea resins. Use air conditioning and dehumidifiers to maintain moderate temperatures and reduce humidity levels to minimize off-gassing. Increase ventilation, particularly after bringing new sources of formaldehyde into the home. These are just a few tips that can help the indoor air quality in your home. For a list of qualified indoor air quality professionals in your area, visit the website shown on the screen.
IAQ TV, the place to be.